The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that.
That makes it second and 10.
Yellow two, yellow three.
Motion.
Yellow three.
Screen pass. He's got his halfback. They'll bring him down at the 20. That's a loss of about five.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
It's third down and 15 to go. Ball on their own 20. Knocked out immediately after the catch.
It's a great job here by the quarterback of recognizing the outside linebacker blitz and delivering the football for a first down.
Tackle at about the 45. The draw play to the running back gives him 8 or 9 yards.
That makes it second and 2.
Down after a nice run up the middle. First down grab by the receiver. He's taken down at the 35. Makes it out to about the 26.
That makes it second and 2.
He guns it to the right. Intercepted.
This quarterback better start making better decisions in the passing game. Otherwise, this corner will come up with even more picks in the future.
First down. Tough spot here, deep in their own territory.
Hey, check by 45. Check
by 45. And he's taken down right around the 2-yard line. He's tackled at the 3. Gets to about the 5-yard line.
This is a good call by the defensive coordinator. He guessed run, and when the offense came with it, his guys were in position to make the stop.
He really got a hold of that one. He gets out to about the 42-yard line. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency.
Watch the run, watch the run.
Zips it to the back. And he's tackled at the 27-yard line.
I like how the offense is using the pass to get him involved. He's explosive, and you just want to get the ball in his hands.
And he is drilled at the 8-yard line. Down at
what an offensive lineman hopes for, an opportunity to impose his will on the defense.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. So a four-play, 41-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. The score now, 7-0. Tennessee kicked this one off. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 21-yard line. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Gets out to around the 32.
He got the ball, and he was off like a shot. This guy has some big-time speed.
He's got it out to his tight end, and down he goes at the 38. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
He makes it to the 38-yard line. They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. Booming kick.
Great job by the punter of getting the ball inside the 20 and turning over field position for his defense.
A touchdown was the end result of their last drive as this offense moved the ball very well with their passing game.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
He scrambled and picked up a couple of yards. Tennessee is up 7. Takes the ball inside. He makes it to the 9. He scrambled. Tackle made at the 10.
That's a gain of 1 on the play. That brings us 4th and 7.
He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. The Volunteers are smothering the opposition so far today. What's this offense got to do to get off the schneid?
Well, you talk to offensive coordinators about that, and they'll say we've got to find our go-to guy. Who are our players that we know we can count on, and what are the plays that we typically feel the most confident about? That's usually where the offenses tend to go when they're getting shut down.
That's a great tackle at the 25-yard line.
That's a gain of 11 on the play.
First down.
Folks, that's the end of quarter number 1, and we got a pretty good ball game on our hands so far. The Volunteers with a touchdown lead. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. Gets to about the 24-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. He gets hit out of bounds at the 18-yard line. It's up, and it's through the uprights. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the one. He's tackled at the 24-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Tennessee holds a four-point lead. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
You can't blame him for not hanging on to that pass. He got hit pretty hard.
From their own 24-yard line. Second down. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers.
Red, two, go!
And they make the stop at the 32. Five wide. Good tackle there in space. First down.
Yeah, they brought the linebackers here on a blitz, and they vacated some space in the secondary. He had more than enough room to pick up the first down.
Scrambling around. They'll bring him down around the 47-yard line.
That's a gain of four on the play.
This is the eighth play of this drive. He goes out of bounds at the 43-yard line. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Tennessee is up four. And now he pitches it. He fights forward to about the 43.
Well, they decided to go for it, but the defense slammed the door on him. That's the definition of coming through when it matters most.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Tackles him hard at the 40-yard line.
Well, the question now is, how will they respond after losing a couple on that run?
From their own 40-yard line, second down. A screen pass gets it to the back. He's pushed out of bounds at the 43. He gets sacked on the play.
You know what happened there? The offensive line was so focused on picking up the blitz, they forgot about blocking the defensive lineman.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Get this one off, and it's a beauty. He fields the punt at the 20, and he's tackled at the 28-yard line. Both defenses really played well so far, Herbie.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Quads, quads, quads.
Now he tries to buy some time. Brought down in the open field.
That makes it second and six.
Tennessee is up by four.
Easy.
Fires it out. Tackle around the 36-yard line. Like they didn't get the playoff quick enough.
Delay of game. Offense.
They'll give this one another try.
Still
after the flag.
And on third down, too. That's when you don't want those kind of things to happen.
Three down. From their own 31-yard line, it's third down.
Kill.
There's a strike complete, and he hits him hard at the 33, and they pick up 2 yards.
Well, it's a good job here to just secure the football, but he just doesn't have enough speed to turn that into something big.
They're coming after this punter. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. Tackle made at the 25. Akron's coaching staff, I've got to think, going into halftime, and we're getting close right now, Kirk. They've got to do something different. What they had planned with their star running backs is not working today.
Well, I think the continuity between a coaching staff and a quarterback and an offense is tested. Their star player is not having a great game. They're losing this football game. I think now is we're close to this half. Now is when you start to think about what other ways can we attack this defense. And then maybe eventually we get back to our star running back. But in the meantime, let's try to find some other ways to attack to be able to put points up.
Throws it to the outside. Almost intercepted.
It's an intelligent play by the defender. All you have to do sometimes is get your hand on the ball.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. He's to the 40. Gets to around the 42. The Zips are going to call their second timeout. He's hit immediately.
That brings up second and one.
Makes the grab past the marker.
That makes it first and ten.
Just throws this one away. So both teams will go to the locker room looking to make some adjustments and find some second half offense. Tennessee leads it 7-3.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. Both of these offenses have proven to be capable of making explosive plays, and really we expected to see a lot of that in this game. Haven't seen it so far. You know, David, this game reminds me a lot of the 2012 Stanford-Oregon game when the Stanford defense did such a great job of limiting Oregon's big plays.
Yeah, and Oregon's an offense that thrives on the big plays, and you see them go the length of the field all the time, and how fast. I mean, just a blink of an eye, you can see it. But what about when you make them execute on third down? What about when you make them execute on third and short? And then you put them in field goal position or field goal range, and you make them decide whether they want to kick a field goal on fourth and short because they don't really feel comfortable getting it. When you make an offense go the length of the field and execute, that's when turnovers happen. You need somebody to slip up and make one mistake. If they put 12, 13, 14 plays together as opposed to 4 or 5, the likelihood of that mistake coming very much swings in favor of you.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. It's going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
Boy, I hope the second half's as good as the first. Just about set to start the third quarter in a tight one. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Tennessee's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Knocked out of bounds at about the 43-yard line. Nice run there as they work the outside.
That's good for gain of 4 yards. That brings him second and 5.
Watch seven. Watch seven. I got you. Check
check check check check. He tackles him for a loss. They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. And they push him out right around the 36-yard line.
Gain of 18 on the play.
Hey, check my
45.
Check my 45. Come on, 16. I'm coming, 16. You mine. You're mine, baby. I'm in your head all day, baby. Come on.
Makes the catch, and look out. He's tackled at about the 29-yard line.
Did you see how he looked that ball into his hands? That's how you catch a football.
That'll make it second and 4.
Tackled after a decent pickup.
Call the game 6 yards.
First and 10, ball on the 23-yard line.
Tight right, tight right.
Four down, four down. 45's the mic.
Read out.
Now he's scrambling inside the 10. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
Room around the corner, and he is drilled at the 2. Touchdown, Zips. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. He makes the PAT. Akron is ready to kick it away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
I think this defense has played well enough to be able to win this game, obviously. But at some point, you'd love to see their own offense feed off of some of the confidence that their defense is playing with, because up to this point, the defense is keeping them in the game, but the offense isn't quite doing enough to be able to build on that lead.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Fires quickly, and he's got his man, and he's taken down at the 36-yard line. They come out in an empty backfield. Throws complete. He's got room to work. He's knocked out of bounds right around the 42-yard line.
That'll make it second and 4.
Got some open field. He's taken down at the 42-yard line. Quarterback down.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
Second and long.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack at second and long.
Four down, four down. Hey, check Mike 47. Check Mike 47.
watch out here. And he shoved out of bounds right around the 44-yard line.
As an offensive line, you've got to do a better job as a group at communicating. The defense brought pressure. That time, they did not do a good job of picking up the linebackers. The linebacker was able to come up with a sack.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The quarterback did a really good job in the last drive of finding his receivers in space, and I bet he'll be looking to do the same thing again.
Akron is up a field goal. Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage.
That's a 6-6 on the play.
Man left, man left.
Make it second and four.
On the delay. Nice run, and he's brought down.
Carries the ball. Gain of 7 yards. First down.
He gets hit out of bounds. Right around the 34.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and 9.
He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
Number 7 was the intended receiver on the play.
Third and 9. Ball on the 34.
It's just me and you.
Under heavy pressure. That's a great tackle at the 26.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. They found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. Oh, excellent punt. Made a few guys miss on his way to a quality return. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Quickly, and it's almost intercepted.
Yeah, the quarterback's breathing a huge sigh of relief because he got away with throwing what should have been an interception.
It's second and 10. Ball on their own 33. Brought down at about the 47-yard line. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was in bounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
After review, they decided that the call on the field will stand. The 37-yard line. First down.
47, Mike. 47.
Red two.
He might not be able to get the pass off. Dives for extra yardage. Slings it. Inside the 10. Now it's first and goal as he's knocked out after a nice game. Touchdown, Volunteers.
Boy, he looked determined running the football. Nobody was going to keep him. him out of the end zone.
And I'll tell you, a four-point lead is not a comfortable one, especially in a dogfight like this one.
And he hits the PAT. So a six-play, 67-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. So the score now, 14-10. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Both teams are kind of struggling to take control of this game. Obviously, they're both very, very competitive with one another. It just seems that the lead is going back and forth between the two teams.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Throws it, and it's tipped away. From their own 25-yard line, second down. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. He's pushed out of bounds at the 37-yard line. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds.
That makes it first and 10.
Throws it in a hurry. Tackle made at the 49. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
And that's it for quarter number three. Folks, we got a great game on our hands. Tennessee's up by four. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
Tight end right. Four down. Five's the mic. Three down.
Motion.
225.
Take motion.
Motion.
He's at the 40. He makes his way out to about the 35. And he just gets rid of it. From the 35-yard line, second down. As a man, he'll lose big yards. 5-yard loss on the play.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. The cavalry's coming. And he's immediately tackled. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
Number 44 brings him down at the 25-yard line. First down.
And down he goes at the 23.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That brings up second and 9.
Quick out to his receiver. They'll bring him down at the 13.
Number 24 brings him down at the 13-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
He gets rid of this one. From the 13-yard line, second down. Touchdown, and they take the lead.
Oh, that's a great job of some tough running right there. When you get close to the end zone, things get very tight. It's tough to maneuver.
Trying to go up by three, they'll kick the extra point. And he converts the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. It's second and 15. Ball on the 20.
47, Mike. Black five.
And he's tackled around the 28-yard line. A nice job by the offensive line, and they pick up a gain of 8. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. He goes out of bounds at the 31. And watch out. They're going to bring the heat right here. A score here might effectively end this one. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Catches it, and he's looking for more. He steps out to 39-yard line.
Game of 14 on the play. First down.
Hey, check Mike 45. Check Mike 45.
Let's go heavy. Let's go heavy. Heavy, what you got? What you got, heavy?
Alert! Alert!
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Tackle around the 44-yard line.
Number 35 on the tackle. The 44-yard line. First down.
He's out of bounds at the 43-yard line.
Not that impressive of a play. Let's see if they continue to employ the short passing game or if they decide to run the ball.
I can't believe they let you play. I can't believe they even let you play.
Passes to the wide out, and he can't pull it in. Third down now. They need to get it down to the 34.
That'll make it 39.
Hauls it in. And a huge touchdown play. And he adds the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. And scooped up. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. From their own 23-yard line. First down. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Red two.
Kill, kill.
Panther two.
Looks for the tight end, but they can't hook up.
That brings us
third and 10. Ball on the 23. He's wrapped up for the sack. They've been all over this quarterback today.
The pass protection has got to do a better job, but give this defense some credit. They've really figured out what they have to do to pressure the quarterback and to cause him some problems.
gets it away. And this is a really nice punt. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. The offense now will take the field, and they hope to have the same success they had on their last drive.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something, because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
The Volunteers call a timeout. That's their second of the half. Second down and six. Ball on their own 35. Tennessee's out of timeout.
He was never able to get ahead of steam on that carry.
Just under 2 minutes in the game. Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds.
That is money in the bank. Sometimes you just can't stop a good combination.
From their own 44-yard line, it's first down. Nice run up the middle.
Makes the tackle. Gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and five.
They're going to 88. They're going to 88. All you get is a headache. All you get is a headache. Cut. Reach out. 794. Get it.
He's taken down around the 47-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. He might have a chance, and he's taken down around the 42-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. And this one comes to an end. Our final count in this game, 24-14, Akron. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.